Hi, so as I was mentioning the other time, the last one is a concept question, which is the one that most of you are reluctant to attempt. All right, which is fine. You just need to make sure you are good in at least one or preferably at least two. But I'll still, for the sake of those who are interested in attempting this question, I'll still go through with it. All right. It's actually one of my favorite questions because in terms of evidence, it has the least demands for evidence because it's actually quite easy to refer to any incident throughout the book without having to go in detail. But what's important or essential for this is to be able to reframe concepts in your own words. For example, as we went through the other time, what honor, justice, and law refers to. Okay? So you really need to have some understanding, have had some prior discussion or brainstorming, especially in class, about these concepts. I know that we don't always have time to go through every single one, but you can raise your own to me, right? And I can give you feedback on it. So today's one, oh, right. So yeah, in your own words, generally the difficulty of all these questions are the same. It's just that, in terms of understanding, the least needed is for character, followed by relationship, and then the most is concept. And then the demand for evidence or the detail or the number of scenes you need to study starts very high with character and then gets less with relationship and even less with concept. Okay, so if you think about it this way, it all turns out to be the same difficulty. All right, so moving on to talk about humor in Charcot. First of all, perhaps you could watch the video over here and think about what makes this funny, or rather, what are Key and Peele criticizing when they make this video? And how is that criticism created? After watching this video, I hope you realize that most of this criticism hinges on displaying the opposite of what happens in real life. Everything they say where this doesn't happen, where this doesn't happen, is actually saying, criticizing what really happens in America. And the framing, of course, helps as well because it provides a nice contrast between, I mean, it shows that the whole song and dance are in fantasy land, which is never going to happen, which makes it even more sad by emphasizing that the possibility of these nice things happening is as much as, you know, your dreams. So by implying the negative and by contrasting with reality, these are two main things you should note, which also applies to this. All right. Well, I like this question. Two things. One, because it talks about humor, which is one of the main themes in this story. And two, because it talks about Charcot. Now, we've never really studied Charcot as a character in itself, but how the Charcotians, how the townspeople behave, is actually something you should look at. If you recall, page one, where Mr. Chawla describes the news, that's actually one instance of how the Charcotians behave on how they think. All right, I'm going to mention some other examples, which is page 27. If you turn to that page, it's the page which describes how the people treat the government building of the post office. Page 57, which is what I'm going to emphasize today, is about how about families, so society's expectations of women. Some other pages you can turn to, because I know there's only three, the civil servants, what call it? Oh, you can you know, the brigadier, the police inspector, the chief medical officer, and maybe the district collector. Yeah, these four you can say represent the people. Another good scene you can think of is page 160, where they divide themselves into two camps, right, for and against the monkeys. Okay, going to page 57, which is what I'm going to focus on. This scene is actually quite easy. Basically, you notice that it's all about expectations of the girl, right? And on page 59, you notice it's contrasted to the boy, which is very simple, and the expectation is, let's see. This, after all, is the boy's family. Yeah, all they need is just to have a sense of pride, which is not only simple in contrast to the many demands the girl must have, but also think about it, pride compared to like physical appearance, being smart, being socially appropriate. Pride is like an empty, very empty value, right? So both the quantity and the quality of their values. So if you realize all of this is, okay, first of all, you have to establish how is this a humorous event, right? You can say it's humorous because it's an exaggeration, right? And exaggeration deals with the quantity of the characteristics the girl needs compared to what the guy has, right? And then you can talk about the quality or the contrast, right? Which is criticism, right? It's criticizing Charcot for expecting so much of women, but then expecting so little of men. So what criticism is this? Unfairness, inequality, discrimination. Yes, that's right. So that's how it's being criticized through humor. The humor being how the females have so much compared to the guys, which is an exaggeration, right? I think I've gone through before the concept or what's required for humor, right? Exaggeration is one of them. Contrast is another. And second, so we have the humor here. And second is the criticism of inequality between men and women. And that's it. It's pretty easy if you realize. But your understanding must be very sharp in being able to break down the concept, just as I've shown you. Right? Try likewise for page 27, page 1, or even, what's that, 160, right? Or even anywhere. Whoops, how come it's not being shown? Eh, oh, okay. Or anywhere with the civil servants, the brigadier, CMO, scientist, Vermaji, and what's called, who's the last one? Oh, police superintendent. Yeah, okay. Please, please, please do not, okay. I know that she criticizes Charcot through perhaps how the neighbors treated Kufi and all that, but you know, you're not going to find much humor there. If you want to try something else, please go ahead. I encourage you to experiment, be daring, and try whatever you want so that you make the mistakes here in class rather than the exam. But yeah, please be careful of like catering only to criticism and ignoring or forgetting about humor. Right, so that's all the advice I have. Please try your best. Thank you.